All right, this is our first time listening to Divinals. Listen to the song, I Touch Myself. And today we have joining us my brother, Bert. That could have sounded weird if I went right from that song title to Bert. Like, I just could have got weird, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Let's get into it.
All right.
Okay, how do you guys like it so far?
It's pretty interesting. Seems like it might be about self-love, maybe.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, that is a good way to describe it. Definitely a song about self-love. About this song was strange, okay? There was nothing regular about this. So what'd you guys think? Birdo, how'd you like it? Is this a relatable song for you? No, but really, she seemed kind of psycho, you know what I mean?
She does seem psycho.
At first, I was like, oh, you know, I appreciate her dedication to her man, but I don't think she was singing about her man.
Right.
But maybe she was singing about a man. But I was like, oh, it's nice. You know, she's dedicated. And probably not the type to just go out and cheat and all this stuff. But then as the song kept going on, I started listening more closely. I was like, oh, no, this isn't dedication. This is psychosis.
Right.
You know what I mean? I love myself. I want you to love me. Like, that's
the... I touch myself.
That's the qualifier for wanting someone to love you? Just saying, right. I love myself. I want you to love me. And I was like, oh, man. And then the faces she was making, she was saying some crazy stuff.
Right. That was like an 80s strip club song.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Is that what people were going around singing back in the day? You know, in the grocery store, you'll hear someone singing a song.
Right, was that like a grocery store song?
Is that like what people were singing way back in the day?
That explains how we got to social media modern day.
Right, and all the, you know, X-rated sites modern day.
Right, you know?
And what was that with that little flexible little pose?
Yeah. Yeah. If she started dancing, she'd be like, and then she'd be like,
then just juke?
Yeah. 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 And then, like, yeah, that one girl was like flipping over, like licking her, like underside. Like, I was like,
what?
The
faces she was making
that.
Really made her seem crazy.
It did.
Oh, my goodness. She just seemed a little obsessive. Like, that's not the one you want to break up with because she might kill you.
She might kill you.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
No, really, she was that level of obsessed with the dude.
Yeah.
I was kind of like waiting for her to like say some more normal things, but she just kept.
Then you realize, like, she's not normal.
Maybe
it's never coming.
It's never.
Maybe it was just like intrapersonal communication. Like, she's just like we're just listening to her thoughts, and she just keeps thinking that.
She's
but
like,
that doesn't make it too much better, I guess. Yeah. But yeah. But it was interesting. Yeah, she was a character for sure. She was a character.
Wow.
But did you guys like the song? Like the music?
Yeah, it was catchy. I'll say that. It was catchy.
It was
pretty catchy.
I just hope that doesn't get stuck in my head and I like start walking around singing that.
Oh,
she's just dancing, looking at the camera the whole time.
Now, you picture me in Publix or something. I touch myself. I really do.
I
hope. Because sometimes a song gets stuck in your head, you just blurt them out, you know?
Right.
So hopefully that
doesn't
happen.
Yeah, you especially.
Yeah, I can't see myself just singing, repeating those lyrics.
Hopefully, I just forget we ever even listened to the song. I do not want that stuck in my head.
Erase.
I do not want it stuck in my head. Definitely not.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. Where to go? She told me, boy, you to go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.